Assalamualaikum, this is Dr. Savira and today I'm with you with the lecture of nutrition in pregnancy. So by the end of the lecture you should be able to outline the nutrients required during pregnancy, the food sources of the nutrients and what is the importance of nutritionally adequate diet in pregnancy. Nutrition, which we have been discussing in this module from the beginning with you. So nutrition is the nourishment or energy that is obtained from the food which is being consumed, or in other words, it is the process of taking in food and using it for growth, metabolism and repair of the different body functions that are going on. So what is good nutrition? Good nutrition means obtaining the right amount of nutrients from healthy foods in right combinations. So it's, as you can see, that a number of food they have good nutritive value, but if they are not taken in right amounts, it can be harmful for the body or of no use to the body. So what is pregnancy? It is the state of carrying or a developing embryo or fetus within the female body in the uterus. A normal pregnancy lasts for about 40 weeks or 9 months roughly, from the first day of the last menstrual period to the birth of the baby. During pregnancy, what is the importance of eating a healthy diet? Eating a nutritious diet during pregnancy is linked to a good fetal brain development, a healthy birth weight, and reduces the risk of many birth defects. It maintains a normal maternal body tissues. A balanced diet also reduces the risk of nutritional deficiencies and decreases the unusual symptoms of pregnancy, such as fatigue and morning sickness. When you are dealing with pregnant women or non-pregnant women or the general population, there are certain healthy eating trends and certain non-healthy eating trends. So the patients having healthy eating trends, they are having a balanced diet, having light regular physical activity, plenty of fluids and avoidance of addictive foods like pan, chalia and tobacco. While unhealthy eating trends are irregular meal times, sweet and carbonated drinks, and high fat food intake. So there are certain nutrients that are recommended during pregnancy, which includes the major food groups, which are the macronutrients, carbohydrates, proteins and fats, and the micronutrients, vitamins and minerals. So micro means required in very small quantities and macro required in comparatively larger quantities, or forming the main bulk of the food. Carbohydrates, which are the primary energy source of a pregnant woman, and 50-20% of the total calories consumed daily constitutes of carbohydrates. It promotes the weight gain of the fetus, the development of the placenta, and fulfills other energy requirements of the maternal body tissues. So the food sources which can be advised to the women of carbohydrates are cereals, bread, rice, pasta, fruits and vegetables that are grown as roots, bananas, sugar and milk. You should have knowledge of what are good carbohydrates and what are bad carbohydrates. Good carbohydrates are those foods which have more fibers, high content of minerals and vitamins, and have low glycemic index. And you require fewer calories while you are taking the food. While bad carbohydrates, they are low in fiber and nutrients, they have high glycemic index, and you need a lot of calories to make you feel full, which include sugars, jaggeries and candies and refined grains. So once you have knowledge that what are good carbohydrates, it would be easier for you to recommend the pregnant women to take during their food. Protein constitutes 15 to 20% of the daily calories. It is required for fetal growth, placental development, production of amniotic fluid. It is the fluid present in the bag in which the baby moves. It is increases the maternal blood volume, and it is involved in the growth of the maternal tissues. The daily requirement is approximately of 62.5 grams per day. 82% of the total demand of the protein required for maternal needs and fetal needs is in the last half of the gestation, where the growth of the fetus is more as compared from the earlier gestation. Inadequate maternal protein intake increases the risk of low birth weight. Advise the women taking alternative sources of proteins, which are dairy products, pulses, nuts, as compared to fish. But again, fish is the best sources of proteins. Now, the pictorial representation of the vegetarian sources of the or non-meat sources of protein. Now, the third macronutrient, which is fats, it constitute 20 to 30% of the daily calories. It is important for the growth and development of the fetus, and it is important for the fetal brain and eye development. Foods which are rich in fat again are fat, meat, dairy products, nuts, and fruit like avocados. A pregnant woman will be requiring small amounts of all water-soluble vitamins, like but we'll be discussing here the two most important water-soluble vitamins, which is folate and vitamin B6, which has an important role in the growth and development of the fetus. Folate, also called vitamin B9 or folic acid, you might be having heard of this. It is important for the synthesis of nucleic acids and certain amino acids for new cell and tissue production, and it is very important at the growth of the fetus at the cellular level, which occurs in the early days of the pregnancy or just after conception. Impaired folate status during pregnancy may be involved with adverse outcomes such as pregnancy complications as miscarriages, preterm deliveries, and low birth weight. Inadequate maternal folate intake or prior to or in the first few weeks after conception, it appears to play an important role in the development of the neural tube defects, which are defects of the brain, spine, or spinal cord. For this reason, it is very important for women who are planning to conceive to start folic acid consumption prior to pregnancy, 3 months, and in the first 3 months of the pregnancy, until the period of organogenesis is complete. Usually, daily requirement of folic acid is 400 micrograms per day, and it could be taken from food sources or by supplementation of folic acid in the form of medication. The food sources of folate are usually green leafy vegetables, seeds, nuts, papayas, and oranges, which can very easily be included in the diet of the women who are planning to conceive to avoid the complication of fetus having neural tube defects. The second water-soluble vitamin, which is important for the synthesis of non-essential amino acids, heme, red blood cells, proteins, and hormones, is vitamin B6. It reduces the incidence of preeclampsia, which is hypertension in pregnancy, and good Apgar scores, which is good condition of the fetus at the time of delivery, and the neonatal behavior. The need for vitamin B6 predominate in the later half of the pregnancy, but as it is not stored in the body, so increased intake in early pregnancy is not likely to be adequate to meet the demands in later in pregnancy. So a continuous supply of vitamin B6 is required throughout the pregnancy. The daily requirement is very small, which is 1.9 milligram per day. and can be fulfilled by dietary requirements or by taking prenatal and antenatal supplementation, which is being prescribed to the patient. Foods which are commonly eaten by the women are good sources of vitamin B6 are bananas, potatoes, meat, bread, walnuts and sunflower seeds, which can very conveniently be added to the diet of the pregnant woman. So certain minerals which are required in pregnancy, the more important one we are discussing, which is iodine, iron, zinc and calcium. Iodine is a mineral that is essential for healthy brain development in the fetus. Its need increases throughout the pregnancy for the synthesis of thyroid hormone. The daily requirement is about 200 micrograms per day. The foods which are rich in proteins are fish, yogurt, potatoes, eggs, and cranberries, strawberries, turkeys, or chicken. And again, which can be very easily advised and consumed in the diet. Now, the second mineral is iron, which is the most important function of iron is heme synthesis, or which forms hemoglobin. Heme is the protein which is found in the red blood cells. So, as we all know, the function of red blood cell is to transport oxygen from the lungs to the body so that the tissues maintain the basic life functions. It is also important to play the processes by which the cells make energy at the cellular level. It maintains a normal immune system. Women which are deficient in iron are prone to get more sick or develop infections. It contributes to the normal cognitive function. Cognitive function includes brain functions such as memory, concentration, learning and problem solving. So, a person who is deficient in iron will have a confused mind state, unable to perform normal daily activities, feeling lethargic, and that will definitely affect the growth and development of the fetus also. The food sources of iron are fruits and vegetables, fish, spinach, cereals, meat, nuts. So once a woman is consuming a healthy balanced diet, so it is unlikely that she'll develop a deficiency of iron during pregnancy. And certain iron rich foods like pomegranate, watermelon, pineapples, apples, apricots, dates, strawberries. So these are fruits which are available at different seasons of the year. So at every season, usually there is a fruit which is very good in iron, and that can be advised accordingly to the pregnant woman. So the daily requirement of iron during pregnancy is 27 milligrams per day. And along with food, usually we prescribe prenatal iron supplementation throughout the pregnancy so that the deficiency of iron does not occur during pregnancy. Zinc, it is important for the synthesis of nucleic acids, DNA and RNA, and its requirement increases gradually during the pregnancy. In the first trimester, it is 5.5 milligram per day. And in the second trimester 7, and in the third trimester 10 milligram. Foods which are good sources of zinc are pulses, nuts, seeds, meat, cheese, egg and cereals. And others are almond, soya beans and dairy products, peas, fish, meat, oranges and broccoli. So as we have seen that all these minerals and vitamins are present in a number of food sources. So healthy selection of food is very important to avoid the deficiency of these minerals and vitamins. Calcium, it is involved in the mineralization of bones and teeth, energy and cell production, Fetal bone and teeth calcification usually occurs in the third trimester of pregnancy when the requirement of calcium increases. The daily calcium requirement is 1000 mg per day. Deficiency of if the woman is not taking adequate amount of calcium during pregnancy, so the demineralization of bones and teeth of the mother may occur. The main sources of calcium, as we all know conveniently, are the dairy products, but there are certain non-dairy sources of calcium also, which are peas, cabbage, broccoli, cereals, nuts, oranges, and oat, so and fig. So this is also, these are also very good sources of calcium and which can be included in a diet. A healthy woman of average height and build usually requires 1600 to 2400 calories per day. The caloric requirement increases or decreases according to the weight of the woman, but this is of about a healthy average height and build woman. The caloric requirement during pregnancy: in the first trimester, no additional calories are required per day. In the second trimester, additional 350 calories are required, and in the third trimester, additional 500 calories per day are required. So the first trimester are the first 3 months of the pregnancy, second trimester, second 3 months of the pregnancy, and third trimester are the last 3 months of the pregnancy, as we have discussed earlier that pregnancy constitute about 9 months roughly. So in the first trimester, it is the period of rapid cell division, organ development, and preparation for the demand of rapid fetal growth. So in the first trimester, usually the fetus is developing from the time of conception from the cellular level, and rapid growth of the cell occurs, and then the period of organogenesis, in which all the organs start to develop, or is in the first trimester. So this is a critical period, and during this period, along with the macronutrients, which are proteins, fats, and carbohydrates, certain micronutrients are required, which are folic acid, zinc, vitamin B6, and proteins. Calories are not significantly increased during the first trimester of pregnancy, but a healthy nutrient-rich food should be taken in the first trimester along with the nutritional supplement and dairy products to fulfill the need of calcium. In the first trimester, the diet should include good quantity of fruits and vegetables along with the dairy products and whole grains and proteins. So fruits keep the body hydrated, and vegetables are good sources of proteins, minerals, fibers. Dairy products are good sources of calcium, and whole grains provide the main energy source, which is in the form of carbohydrates, and proteins provide essential nutrients like iron, zinc, iodine, and vitamins. In the second trimester or the second 3 months of pregnancy, additional 350 calories are required per day. The macronutrients, proteins, fat, carbohydrates are required, omega essential fatty acids, which is essential for the baby's brain development, and minerals like calcium, iron, magnesium, and vitamin D is required. In the second trimester, again, as you can see in this picture, fruits, vegetables, dairy products, dry fruits, grains, and meat. So fruits and vegetables provide, fruits provide folic acid and essential vitamin D levels, and it helps the citrus fruit, it helps in calcium absorption. Vegetables provide magnesium and calcium, and dairy product can provide calcium and magnesium, which is essential for the development of a healthy fetus. Dry fruits provide calcium and iron. Grains provide the main carbohydrate source, and oatmeal, meat provide the omega 3 fatty acid, which is essential for the brain development. It is important to eat food which constitute all these products to fulfill the requirements during the second trimester of pregnancy. In the third trimester, 500 extra calories are required per day. Nutrients which are required are carbohydrate, proteins and fats, vitamin A, B, C and D, iron and zinc. The food which is consumed in the third trimester needs to boost the energy levels, and as we know that additional 500 calories are required, keeping in view the rapid growth of the fetus and the baby growing in weight and preparing for the delivery. The iron content in the food helps preventing premature delivery and low birth weight. Proteins are important as they act as building blocks in the baby's body. Eggs are rich in selenium, which are healthy for the lungs, and it is rich in zinc, vitamins like A, B and D. So why, once we are discussing that increase in calories are required, the food requirement is increased, so the this is usually required, more calories are required or more nutrition is need in the pregnancy is there, because the metabolic rate is increased, because the fetus needs more and the uterus is growing more rapidly. The basal metabolic rate of the woman increases by 30% as compared to the non-pregnant woman. So overcome these needs or to fulfill these needs, increased calories are required. Pregnancy has a effect on pregnancy. The hormones of the pregnancy has effect on the gastrointestinal tract. Taste often alters. Nausea and vomiting occurs. The whole of the intestinal tract have decreased motility in the first two trimesters with increased absorption of water and salt, and constipation and heartburn also occurs. So while advising patient the different foods, so you have to keep in view these complications of pregnancy that can occur. Fruits and vegetables. So while you can advise a woman that when she is eating food, so half of the plate should be constituting different forms of fruits and vegetables. 1/4 of the plate should be constituting proteins in the form of meat, egg or cereals, and 1/4 of the plate should be consumed as cereals or pulses, and these should be the main energy source in the form of carbohydrates. And you can choose between bread, pasta, rice or healthy starches like beans, potatoes and lentils. So and daily regular physical activity is important. So when you keep in view this plate, it is easier for you to advise the woman how to consume food. So this is a pyramid, and it would be helping you to advise a woman regarding different forms of food. In the lowest part of the pyramid, the main food content should be bread, rice, cereal and pasta. Then fruits and vegetables in quantity lesser than that, and then comes the proteins, and then oils, fat and sugars. So in the end, we conclude that a healthy and nutritious diet leads to a healthy outcome in pregnancy. Thank you. And I think that by the end of this lecture, you will be able to have knowledge of about what should be consumed during pregnancy, what are the good food sources, good carbohydrates, and how to fulfill the nutritional requirement of the pregnant woman.